Here's a very simple game I've done in C++ using the olcPixelGameEngine. I did try to stick to only the stuff that I talked about in this playlist, but if you're confused, you can reach me on my Discord server for more specific topics. In my recent video, the one about keyboard and mouse input, I talked about deltaTime. Today I'm going to talk about fixed timesteps. It's one important concept that went into this project. It means that every single frame is going to be deterministic. In this case, I try to update every 0.008 seconds, which is 1 divided by 120, which roughly translates to 120 frames per second. The olcPixelGameEngine, if you read the documentation, gives you some sample code to do this. You might not get the accuracy down to a single millisecond, but it gets the job done. Basically, we run the while loop, but we don't run the update unless 0.008 seconds have passed since the previous update. Without this, the game can run at 3,000 frames per second, which roughly translates to 0.0003 seconds between frames. This is a gigantic difference, because 0.008 is about 26 times greater than 0.0003. You might say more frames the better, but depending on your machine, everybody's going to get different frame rates, and even worse, with the same machine, depending on the other processes that happen to be running at the same time, you're going to get different frame rates, which means you're going to get varying results depending on the current state and specs of your machine. This means that if you have a character moving in 60 frames per second, it's going to move twice as fast with the same speed if you run it at 120 frames per second. Keeping consistent frame rates across different machines and environments become important. And that's where the concept of fixed timesteps come in. The goal is to get deterministic results in every frame. Starting from the first frame of a punch, you would know exactly how many frames it's going to take to get to that impact. You might have heard of things like frame data in a fighting game where one character uses 2 frames for a jab, while another uses 3 frames for a jab. This means that if the two characters start punching on the exact same frame, the character with the 2 frames is always going to hit first. Unity, as well as many other games or platforms, have a different solution. The concept of delta time, or time between frames, is a workaround where you measure the time between each frame. When you move a character, instead of simply dealing with speed, you multiply speed with delta time. So even if you have different time between each frame, roughly you get the same smooth results. Speed equals distance divided by time, distance equals speed multiplied by time. It's basic algebra. The problem with this is that it's not deterministic. If you do a punch, depending on the machine, you might run the animation in 2 frames or 20 frames. If you have a better gaming rig, you get more frames, and more frames just means that you're going to get smoother interpolation. This might work for certain 3D games, but for pinpoint accuracy, it's not suitable. If you want to check collision at exactly this point in the animation, there's no way to tell how many frames it's going to take to get to that point. You'd have to work with things like how much time has passed, or whether a keyframe or a certain percentage of the animation has passed. If you have a faster machine, you're going to get a point that's slightly behind the time that you want, which is fine, but on a slower machine, that gap is going to be much bigger. It works for most smaller indie games, but you have to rely on the hardware being good enough to run multiple frames between certain points. For mobile devices, which many Unity users go for, it can be difficult because you have limited hardware in very small space. Unity does have the fixed timestep option, which allows you to run fixed updates at your preferred rate, but most likely you're not going to see official documentation telling you to go for fixed timesteps because that puts heavy emphasis on optimization. If you want to use fixed timesteps, you have to guarantee that every update never falls behind that amount of time. For a generalized engine like Unity, that caters to as many developers as possible, it might be less suitable. Even for simple games like this, you might want to think beforehand whether you want to use delta time or fixed time steps. There is no single best answer that applies to everything, but rather you have to make a decision based on your game design as well as target hardware, and so on. I chose fixed time steps because I want to later expand the idea into more complex games that require accuracy and timing. This is a simple example, so it might not make much of a difference here. But as you go deeper and deeper into how video games work, you'll find out that sometimes it's easier to straight up write the code for your game than going through a big generalized engine and building your solution on top of that engine. I implore you to start digging into the world of game programming. Think about the basics as well as the technical details before diving straight into an engine that has thousands of moving parts. That's it for this video. If you have any questions, you can reach me on my Discord server. I have all the links below. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.